second. Carl Edwards Jr. records the save, his 12th of the season. So that'll put a wrap on things here this evening. For my partners, Mark DeRosa, Dan Plezak, and Heidi Watney, this is Matt Vasgersian. This has been a special presentation of MLB Network. Good night, everybody.
3 hours and 4 minutes. Ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of the Braves and everyone at Truist Park, we'd like to thank you for attending and remind you to please drive home safely. Thank you.
From the new home of the Braves, MLB Network welcomes you to Truist Park. Tonight, game two of this three-game series between the San Diego Padres and the Atlanta Braves. Stepping up is Jared Cannon. He was responsible for both of his club's runs batted in last night's ball game. Hit in the air down the left field line. Ozuna is under it. And that's the first out of the inning. And the runner, not tagging, will retreat to second base. So one down, no one aboard. And up next is Key Brian Hayes.
Key Brian.
On its way, the 0-2 pitch. Bit of a surprise here as he's going to try to lay one down. And he'll step on first himself for the out.
Well, you know, he had a good idea right there. The infield was playing back, but it's not going to work out for him this time. That's a nice play to react, and they take.
Now it'll be Jared Cannon, flew out last time up. Ready with the first pitch, here it comes. And that's cut on and missed, 0-1.
Hey, if you're able to blow a first pitch fastball by a guy, gotta believe that pitch is coming again right here.
And he fouls this one off.
I think a big reason why he's been so effective in this one, that he's been just about getting ahead of every hitter. Seems like every one of them are 0-2, 1-2, and it's just about every at-bat. And when that's the case, your chances of getting a good pitch to hit are way worse.
Into the windup and the pitch. In the dirt, but swung on and missed. Zunino gathers it. The throw to first is in time, one down. Digging in next, Jared Cannon. He went down on strikes in his last at-bat. First pitch of the AB now. Fouled away. Ready with the nothing and one pitch. Tries to shave the corner with that pitch, but it's 1-1. Curveball fooled him there as he's way out in front. And he lays off the fastball away, so it's 2-2 now.
We just saw a fastball right there. I would not be shocked if he tries to get this guy to go fishing right here and drops a little off-speed pitch in the dirt.
A great pitch there as he couldn't get extended on that one, and he's down on strikes for the second out. Ready now is Jared Cannon. 0 for 3 with a couple of strikeouts for him to this point in the ballgame.
Down by one. I'm interested to see how they approach this as an offense, especially if they get someone on base early in the inning. Some teams, you know, they're going to try and manufacture that run, just trying to get that one run across. Others, they're going to look for one or two big swings to make it happen.
And here's a foul ball just off to the right as they get ahead of him here, nothing and two. Looking for the strikeout. Here's the 0-2 pitch. And he struck out again. That's the third time he's gone down on strikes in this one. What's your take on all the strikeouts we see in the game today, Dan? That was his third tonight, and it seems we're seeing that a lot more these days.
Yeah, Matt, there's been a real change in philosophy as far as hitting in baseball today. A lot of guys think now that...
Big at bat now, and here is Jared Cannon. Needs a hit here to bring the go-ahead run home from third with two away. Here's the first pitch, and he takes ball one. Breaking ball that time that misses out of the zone.
Nowhere to put anybody. 2-0 count, not a good spot to be in as a pitcher.
The 2-0. Bounced that one, but got him to go after it for a strike.
That's evidence of a pitcher and catcher being totally in sync out there. That tells me they both know that's a good pitch for him right now.
Sharp ground ball to third. And he will deliver one of the biggest at-bats of the night. It's a base hit. And this will not be close, and the run will score easily.
Dan, this had all the makings of going extra innings, but right there, a knock to drive in two for your team.
Yeah, D-Ro, that's a huge two RBI base hit here in the top of the ninth inning.
Pulls this one in the air out to left. Ozuna is under it, and he makes the play to end the inning. So two runs on just one base hit, no errors, and a couple of men left. 2, 3, and 4 set to kick off the bottom of the ninth. It's the Padres 4 and the Braves 2. Four to two, the final score tonight. San Diego came through when it mattered in the ninth on the way to the win. Austin Adams gets the win in relief, his second of the year. Edwin Diaz closes the door for the save, his seventh of the campaign. Daytime baseball here on MLB Network. Lots of pink all around for this Mother's Day matchup between the San Diego Padres and the Atlanta Braves. It's baseball on MLB Network, and it's coming up next.
Cannon.
Stepping in next, Jared Cannon. He comes set. Here's the nothing and nothing pitch. Now a big fastball, and he's well behind it with the swing. Guys, one of D-Rose's former employers, the Braves, as they begin play here this afternoon. They dropped another one last time out, and in fact, they've won just twice in their last eight tries.
Yeah, Matty, this is the big one right here. They split the first two games of this series. You want to steal one right here and be feeling good about yourself.
Yeah, D-Ro, I think one of the things you want to do, you get to the third game, you'd like to win this series and finish it off by winning game three. It's always nice to win a series, whether it's at home or on the road, so this is a big one for this ball club.
On to Freeman at first, and there are two away. Stepping in once again is Jared Cannon, grounded out in his last at bat. Now here's the first offering.
With that base running threat on first base, man, does that change the pitcher's whole mentality. This guy at the plate should assume nothing but heaters coming right at him.
Fouled off.
Hey, usually the second time through the order, you start seeing an incorporation of some more off-speed stuff. But this guy's locating and feeling really good about his fastball. Two back-to-back.
Working for the punch-out and the offering. Swing and a miss at one in the dirt. And the throw to first ends the inning. So here is Jared Cannon. He'll lead things off here in this one-run contest. Swung on and missed for the first strike.
Pitcher wants to have a quick inning right here, capitalize on the momentum his batters have.
Oh, and he's really getting the better of him now. It's strike two. Trying to send him packing for the second time.
Step out of the box, take a deep breath. After spitting on that changeup, you might have bought yourself a fastball.
And it's fouled away. Well outside with the curveball for a ball.
This is a fun guy to watch when he's up there. Really battles. Doesn't take any pitches off. He's a grinder. Always seems to make it difficult on the opposing pitcher.
3-2 now. And a good eye here as he takes ball four, and it's a base on balls to lead off the fifth inning. And that'll bring up Fernando Tatis Jr. He's singled in two trips to the plate thus far. Here now the 2-2. Swung on and missed. He got him on strikes. Next to stand in is Manny Machado. He was sat down on strikes in his last at-bat. The 0-2 pitch. Now a swing and a little bouncer softly hit to the right side of the mound. And he won't even think about second as he'll flip on to first for the sure out. Here's Randy Arozarena trying here to plate the tying run from second. A bouncer to the left side. Gonna be a tough play. Throw in time and the side is retired. Padres leave one. They still trail it here 4-3. So the next to bat will be Jared Cannon. Here's the first pitch. And he fouls this one off. Comes set and the 0-1. Fouled away. Hoping to send him packing. Pitch on its way.
Hey, every ball club has that spark plug guy, and this is the guy right here. He usually ignites a lot of productive innings.
Here comes the 1-2. Is looked at for ball number two.
We've got ourselves an awesome battle going on right here. Bottom line, the guy who's going to win this situation is the guy who executes.
Hit high and deep out to left. A ball that's carrying. On the warning track, he makes the catch. And stepping in, Jared Cannon. The base knocked to the outfield could score the tying run from second. He's set. Here it comes. Now a ball hit hard toward first. And this gets down. Extra bases. And this could change everything. Here's the tying run to score. Now it's cut off. A throw to the plate. The tag. And he is out at the plate as two runs score, but not the third. Up next is Fernando Tatis Jr., the runner in scoring position with two gone. Swung on and hit deep to left center. This one has a chance. And he gets there, makes the running play, and
this manager appeals to his hitters to be more discerning at the plate.
An overcast night here in Southern California as we welcome you inside Petco Park in San Diego. Tonight we get the week started. It's Padres baseball on the show. Brandon Waddell will be on the mound for the series opener. What do you have for us on him, Danny? And now, Jared Cannon. No one aboard for him, and two gone here in the first. Here's the pitch. Fouled off. Oh, and one count, and the pitch. Chased a low ball there, and he's quickly down in the count 0-2.
Wow, great pitch right there, right? Changing speeds. How about that straight changeup? How about that swing? Howdy, if you're waving at me.
Count remains at 0-2. Into the windup and the pitch. He chases out of the zone for strike three, and that's the third out of the inning. In the box, Jared Cannon. He'll lead things off here in this one-run contest. On a less than impressive swing there to start the at-bat, it's 0-1.
If this offense is going to be this aggressive, I'm going to expect this pitcher and catcher combo to expand the zone.
And that one yanked just foul. And now a pitch on the way. Not a bad pitch there with two strikes, but it misses 1-2. Way inside with that one, a pretty easy take there.
Well, he kind of got caught chasing the first two pitches out of the strike zone, but I think he's caught onto their game a little bit right now. Two tough pitches that he took with two strikes, and now the count is 2-2.
Something has to give. Here's the payoff pitch. Hit on the ground to third. Beautiful diving stop, and the first out of the inning is a beautiful one. What a play.
That ball almost got through the hole right there.
Up next, Jared Cannon. He bounced out last time up. Starts him out with a changeup off the plate for ball one. Swinging a blooper to the right side. Right fielder coming on, but he won't get there. It falls in.
Hey, after that hit right there, D'Lo, that extends his hitting streak to 6 games.
Yeah, no doubt about it. 6 days in a row with Knox will help you sleep better at night, Dan.
The center fielder, Randy.
The 2-2 popped up. Thomas is there, and the side is retired. One left for San Diego as it remains a 6-5 ball game. Leading off the inning, it'll be Jared Cannon, and they could use a spark from him here. First delivery to him. Hard hit towards center. Allen is there, and he has it for the first out.
Jumped all over that first pitch of the inning, and he didn't miss.
So next to bat will be Jared Cannon. He comes to the plate as the last chance for his side. Two out here in the ninth. First pitch here is hit off to the right side and foul. It's strike one. The 0-1 on its way. Good pitch as this is swung on and missed. And now they're down to perhaps their final strike of the evening. As we near the end of this one, I think it's safe to say that the story of the game is. And here's a foul tip. Held on to strike three, and that's the ball game. An 11-7 final in this one. The Nationals posted 11 runs on the scoreboard when it was all said and done. Sterling Sharp takes the win on the mound, his second of the year. Petco Park here on a Tuesday night. Tonight. Now at the plate is Jared Cannon. Strasburg with a check at first and a dive, but he's back in there. First pitch on the way. The 0-1 pitch. So, guys, these Nationals, as they interplay here tonight, they're definitely in a nice stretch as they've won 6 of their last 7 ball games.
Yeah, Matty, I always felt like these were huge games, whether it's earlier in the season or later in the season, to find a way to get to 500. You feel like you can start fresh and start pushing in a different direction. You cannot continue to ride that seesaw of win one, lose one. This team has to get hot. Starts today.
So now here is Fernando Tatis Jr. looking to put them ahead early with this at bat. A line shot to third base. Throw back to the bag, and the runner's back in time. Here's Manny Machado now. Couple of hits for him and 4 trips to the plate last night. The set and the 1-2. And he gets him to pop it up on the right side of the infield. Keboom puts the glove to it, and the side is retired. Padres leave a pair, and it.
Three.
Ready to go for the last half of the inning, and next it'll be the fleet-footed first baseman, Jared Cannon. And now a pitch on the way, and a fastball to start things out here. Not close, it's a ball and no strikes.
This guy's been really on point so far, but it's not getting any easier. He has to get through 4, 5, and 6 right here.
Can't sit back long enough, and the count evens up at 1-1.
The offense better get it going right here, because they certainly can tell from their dugout. This guy is carrying himself with a presence out on the mound. He's got feel for all his pitches.
The count now at 2-1. And he can't catch the corner here, so he's behind 3-1.
Team's been struggling on offense. Let your D work for you right here. Pound the zone.
Hit in the air down the right field line.
You don't see too many guys at this level be late on off-speed pitches right there. That tells me he was totally sitting on something else or was going automatic take.
And here's a ball lifted high into foul ground down the right field line. Robles is over near the stands as he makes the catch for the first down. Now at the plate, Jared Cannon. And through five turns at bat, they've only mustered a total of three hits. Not terrible, but they're certainly not firing on all cylinders.
Well, it's getting a little bit too late in this game, but this continues like this. In today's game, with so many dominant bullpen arms, you certainly don't want to wait until the eighth or ninth to try to wake the bats up.
Well, and he's got him in the palm of his hand now. It's 0-2.
So he goes back to back with the same pitch and got him to chase it both times. He's clearly not picking up that pitch very well.
So he was confident doubling up. Does he triple up on it?
It's always tough to go back to back to back. It's not a good idea to show a good hitter the same pitch three times in a row.
So a runner at first now with nobody out. And that'll bring up the outfielder Victor Robles. And this is on the ground to short. Could be two. To second for one. On to first, and they get the double play. Next to hit, Jared Cannon. Two away here in the eighth, and time's running out on him, Danny.
Yeah, they don't have a lot of outs left to work with, so it's time for someone to make something happen if they're going to get back into this thing.
We're in the eighth inning now of a 5-2 ball game. Fooled pretty badly there as he reaches to poke this one foul. The 0-2 delivery. Now a swing and a softly hit ground ball. But a foul ball, and the count holds at 0-2. Neither guy giving in here, and they'll do it again. Two runs, four hits. No errors in the ballgame for the Padres. Strike three on a pitch in the dirt. The throw to first is in time, and the inning is over. So they breeze through. And this evening's ends at a 7-2 finish. Washington wrote an important sixth inning to victory in this one.
Victorious Washington Nationals, 7 runs on 10 hits, no error.
An overcast night here in Southern California. So now to the plate, Jared Cannon. Ready to deliver, here comes the first pitch. Means has found success in his career at limiting base hits. He usually turns in outings where his hits per nine numbers are really respectable, and obviously that goes a long way as a starting pitcher.
Matty V, there's a couple of things that really hurt you when you're a starting pitcher. Walks and giving up many base hits per nine innings. This guy keeps the ball in play, doesn't give up a lot of hits, doesn't walk very many batters, and when you do that, it's a good recipe for success, and it's worked for him so far in his career.
And oh, a big rip at the curveball, but he didn't get it, and he becomes the second casualty of the inning. Bottom of the inning now, and next will be the imposing power bat, Jared Cannon, and it's fouled away. Waved at and missed, and he's behind 0-2.
The offense better get it going right here, because they certainly can tell from their dugout this guy is carrying himself with a presence out on the mound. He's got feel for all his pitches.
Throw on to first is in time to get him, so that'll go down as a strikeout and a 2-3 put out for out. Bottom of the sixth inning now, and next it'll be the fleet-footed first baseman, Jared Cannon. And this is taken outside for ball one. And he fouls this one off. Now the 1-1 pitch. Strike two, swinging.
He's staring a hat trick in the face right now after that swing. He has just got to find a way to zone up a little bit more. You cannot expect to make solid contact chasing stuff outside the zone.
The count now at 2-2. Looking to send him packing again. Fouled away. Another 2-2 offering.
Great AB up until this point. A walk right here could really just infuse some confidence into this lineup.
Struck him out. Struck him out again, I should say. His third punch out of the game. Next up, Jared Cannon. Three at-bats for him in this one, all ending with him going down on strikes. Out in front of it, strike one. Another one fouled off, and he's quickly behind 0-2. Nothing in two count, and the pitch. And he'll strike out here yet again, as it's been a ballgame to forget thus far. 4-2, the final score tonight. The Nats jumped out to an early lead in the first and never looked back. John Means takes the win on the mound, his second of the year.